Yeah, so what role will contextual and attention play in the future of digital advertising? So I actually think it's something, it's probably the thing that's been missing the most from digital. And when I say digital, I mean online display, online video advertising for far too long. You know, as an industry, as planners, as media practitioners, we've focused on cost and reach and performance at the expense of everything else. So, and I think what's happening now is there's a realization, whether that's around brand safety, whether that's because there's so much content out there and so many places to advertise, that people need to start thinking about where we're showing up is as important as how we're getting there and the people that we're trying to target. So the environments that we show up in as brands is as important as the people that we're trying to reach. And really and truly, that's been missing for too long. And if you think about TV planning as an example, that's something that those communities will have been used to for a long time. I was a TV planner many, many years ago, and we always used to think about the programs that our ads were showing up in, whether the context was right, whether that's suited the brand that we were trying to insert into those placements, you know, the time of day. So whether it was evening and we wanted to be kind of in front of families versus soulless viewing. So the context, the environment, the media experience was always something that different planning teams have considered, but that wasn't something that translated well to a digital place. So I think it's really interesting that those things are now coming back. So context, thinking about context, and Havas talk about the three C's, so context, connection, and content, are the three key drivers of attention. And I think attention is the way that we can measure if we're getting that right. If people are actively paying attention, looking at ads, then we've done our job in terms of getting into the right context and getting people engaged. So super important part of how we plan, and attention a super important part of how we measure and optimize. Yeah, so I think the concept of attention has changed quite dramatically. So I've sort of been involved with it since the concept of the attention economy started probably about 4 or 5 years ago now. I think when we started out in this area of attention, it was based on a conversation that was really, there's a lot of media inventory out there, you know, media impressions, media impacts are seemingly infinite. It's not all good, but, and what isn't infinite is user and consumer attention. You know, so companies like Lumen, I think they kind of tried to quantify this with ubiquity, but people may spend 220 minutes a day consuming media, but they spend less than 9 minutes of that time even looking at ads in any way, shape or form. So I've seen stats like we're exposed to 4,000 ad messages a day. We're definitely not paying attention to all of those. We may be exposed to them, but our attention is very, very finite. So really and truly, it's bringing back the human into the planning process, understanding how people are realistically consuming the advertising that we're putting out there. You know, and let's be honest, to most people that aren't in the business, advertising is an inconvenience or an annoyance. So generally speaking, we have to be thinking about how we respect that, how we create the right value exchange, and how we make sure that the advertising we are putting out there is getting the right kind of attention to deliver the results that we want for our brands. So I think in terms of how it's changed, initially that was just a concept. We're now sat here 4 years later talking around creation of shared metrics, so an attentive CPM or attentive reach that we could measure campaigns by, and bodies like the Attention Council, for example, are trying to work out if this is something that needs industry consensus. Do we need it to become a joint industry currency, for example? So I think, you know, the conversation's moved from this idea that we need to be considering humans again, and then that attention is a finite commodity, to should we make this a tradable, measurable media currency?
Yeah, and when it comes to metrics, we hear a lot about viewability, but what do you think is deficient about viewability, and why is attention a better measurement tool?
Yeah, so why is attention potentially a better identifier of outcomes than something like viewability? And this is a visual medium. So everything on the screen in front of me could be viewable. The ad could be 50% on screen for a minimum of 2 seconds, the MRC definition, but I'm more than likely probably doing this. And the one thing that viewability doesn't take into account is what the human in front of the device is doing. And as I mentioned in one of the previous questions, for most people, advertising is an inconvenience. It's not something we're actively trying to engage with. So if people are given the opportunity to avoid it, they most likely are, unless there's something that really grabs them about it. So attention is the one thing that gives us, using eye tracking technology, an understanding as to whether people are more likely viewing and looking at the ad. And I've written papers before and said viewability or viewable doesn't mean viewed. The two things are very, very different. And in lots of the research that I've been involved with, one of the things we see is that if you measure attention to ads, so actually tracking if someone's eyes were on the ads, and you measure viewability at the same time, there are ads that can be viewable that nobody looks at. And there are also ads that often aren't classed as viewable, particularly on mobile devices where the screen is smaller, that are viewed. So sometimes viewability as a standard is underestimating the value of some of the ads for different platforms. But the key thing we pulled out of lots of the research is that when you correlate something like attention and viewability to outcomes like recall or consideration, those impressions that were deemed to be attentive, so people paid attention to, were five times more likely to deliver an uplift in recall or choice than simply viewable impressions. So there is a demonstrable link between attentive impressions and likelihood of an outcome.
Yeah, you raise a good point about attention, especially in this day and age with this concept of second screening and people dividing their attention between their smartphones and TV. So as far as trying to grab people's attention, what role do you think creative plays?
Yeah, so what's the role of creative in grabbing attention? And the short answer is, it's probably the most important thing. I mentioned before how at Havas we talk about the three C's, so connection, context, so basically people, where we're serving the ad and what we're serving, and what we're serving, the content piece, is largely the creative. And in econometric studies, in MMM studies from businesses like Data to Decisions, we often see that creative is given between 50 and 60% of the credit for outcomes for advertising. So there's the role that placing the ad into the right place can help to drive attention, but whether the ad is good or not, or relevant to the user or not, is one of the biggest drivers of attention, without a doubt. And I think at the moment, as an industry, we're trying to solve for the boxes we put the ads in. So, you know, if I put an ad on TV versus an ad on social media or an ad on YouTube, for example, how likely are people going to pay attention based on the context? But the sort of thing we can't do is solve for how good the creative is. But my hope is that what attention can do is create a shared metric between media and creative teams that allow people to start pulling apart the effect of the two. I think it'd be super interesting to be able to see, for example, pre-flight, how strong a piece of creative is using partners who use facial encoding and emotional response to understand what job I need to do and my teams need to do in terms of media planning. So if it's a great piece of creative, maybe I need the media to work less hard at driving attention. And if it's a piece of creative that isn't so strong, we need to be thinking about those placements that can really boost it. So that the role of creative is massive, but my hope for attention is that it can create a sort of shared metric that can help improve the whole ecosystem and ultimately make better creative as well. You know, that I think too much of what we put out there now is part of the reason why people don't like advertising. Controversial opinion, but I don't believe ads are as good as they were 20, 30 years ago. The sort of role of entertainment in advertising in creative is far less than it used to be. So potentially we could be looking at a better ad creative ecosystem.
Now, finally, what do you expect to happen, let's say, in the next year or so in terms of perhaps the advertisers adopting some of these metrics? Is there anything that you think is really top of mind going forward?
Yeah, so advertiser adoption of the metrics. I think where we are now, we've been talking about this for sort of 4 years, for kind of the sort of people that were in it from the beginning. And it feels like there's now a real groundswell of interest and support for it as a concept. So when I talk to clients and brands, really and truly, they're going, this isn't rocket science. We're trying to understand which ads people are, or placements people are trying, we're actually looking at, and we should buy more of that stuff or understand how much we need to be buying. It sounds like a good idea, so let's crack on and do it. So I think there's a real desire to push on and start actually using this stuff in planning, optimization, in measurement. But really and truly, I think we're at the sort of just beyond the early adopter stage and starting to see brands play around with the use of the measurement partners to start measuring how attentive their current buyers are, and pushing now into optimization and further measurement to see how that can improve their buys. So I think really where I'd say we're at a place where everyone goes, yep, get the whole attention thing. How do we now do it and make it scalable and make it something that we can include as part of our way of working? And that's what we're doing at Havas, for example, is we're building attention metrics into our core planning tools so that we can start planning towards measures like attentive reach and attentive seconds to ensure that we're allocating budgets to different channels and formats in the right way to deliver on our promise of more meaningful media.